Hello and welcome. Friends, success is sweet, but sweeter if long delayed and attained through manifold struggles and defeats. Whenever we talk about best computers, expensive mobiles with unique features or notepads, the first name strikes in our mind is Apple. Yes, we are talking about Apple computers, which earned a brand name in the personal computer industry in 20th century. The Apple logo was designed with a bite so that it would not be recognized as another fruit. The color stripes were conceived to make the logo more accessible and to represent the fact that the Apple II could generate graphics in color. Apple's first slogan was "Bite into an Apple," which was coined in the late 1970s. From 1997 to 2002, Apple used the slogan "Think Different" in advertising campaigns. Apple also has a slogan "I Think, Therefore iMac," which was used in 1998 to promote the iMac, and "Say Hello to iPhone" has been used to iPhone advertisements. Another slogan, "Hello," was also used to introduce the original Macintosh, Newton, iMac and iPod. Two college dropouts named Steve Jobs and Steve Wozniak quit their jobs and moved into Steve's garage in Cupertino in 1976. There they came up with an idea of creating an inexpensive and user-friendly computer. Jobs and Wozniak sold their most valuable possessions, a van and two calculators, raising $1,300 with which they started a company. By the end of 1978, Apple was one of the fastest growing companies in the United States, with its products carried by over 100 dealers. The failure of Apple III prompted Vice Chairman Mike Scott to lay off employees in February 1981, a move with which Jobs disagreed, which made Mike Markula the president and Jobs the chairman of the company.
The genius of Steve Jobs is not that he listens to the marketplace focus groups and marketing research, and then he takes that research and he implements it. He does not believe in market research. Market research for Apple Computer is Steve's left hemisphere is connected to his right hemisphere. That's the focus group.
The success of the PowerBook and other products brought increasing revenue, which sometime appeared that Apple could not do anything wrong, introducing fresh new products and generating increasing profits in the process. Apple also introduced a magazine, Mac Addict, from the period between 1989 and 1991, which was the first golden age of Macintosh. Apple has some types of strategies for success, like identifying trends by which to visualize a strategy for a product that met consumer needs. Analyzing the competitors, innovate, which follows a model of creating disruption and focuses on the needs and wants of the consumers rather than improving an existing product. Position of a product, as many computer systems and related products can easily be replicated, finding the ways to extend the life of a product through complementary offerings. Apple is known for their superior customer service by creating and sustaining a superior customer service model with an achievement of competitive advantage. Apple was one of the highly successful companies that bucked the traditional notions of what a corporate culture should look in an organizational hierarchy, as a list of other highly successful firms with similar cultural aspects from the same period includes Southwest Airlines and Microsoft. As a fun-demanding place of work, Apple employees work in the casual dress as well as with a work-hard, play-hard attitude that consider themselves the best. Apple has competitors like Dell, HP, and IBM. Apple has competitors like Dell, HP, and IBM.
We'll be right back.
products in market like Apple One, Apple II Series, Apple Silent Type, Apple Plotter, Apple iPod Photo, iPod Plus HP. Apple's stock price has increased in last 4 years. Shares traded in the $20 in 2004 reached to $85.35 at the end of 2008 and closed at $665.15. Apple was the first $1 trillion company. In 13 years, Apple has transformed itself from organization to the world's most valuable firm. While Apple's approach would not work for every firm, there are lessons to be learned that can influence program design regardless of industry, firm size, or location. Make the employees own their learning, training, and development. Apple frequently produced new products requiring expertise in completely different industries, which was the employee skill that set requirement change faster than at almost any other tech firm. Just as with career progression, employees' training and learning are primarily owned by employees, the firm expects employees to be self-reliant, as the company gave no training on how to sell, but a practice that is certainly unconventional in the retail environment. Apple does, with relentless execution and focus on key factors, even a firm near bankruptcy can fight its way back on the top. The company does not stop here only, as it also introduced the first mobile phone of the fourth and fifth generation technology to the world and proven it as the world's number one company in the gadget world. So friends, success is the sum of small efforts repeated day in and day out. Goodbye and have a successful future.